So that pricing power isn't really there, at least not yet. Sanjay Agarwal is joining us from Kolkata. He's Managing Director, Century Ply. Mr. Agarwal, good morning. Great to have you back on the show. Thank you for your time. Prashant Desai. First up, I'd like to understand what was in the for the fourth quarter results, what was volume growth,
Yeah,
sir,
Prashant, good morning.
For in the plyboard segment?
In the fourth quarter, the top line has gone up by 19%, March 14 compared to March 15. It's gone up from 343 to 409. That is the fourth quarter top line growth actually.
Right. Now, I have the top line growth. I'm talking about what was wh how much of the 19% was volume growth, how much was pricing growth? What was the volume growth specifically?
Actually, I don't have a volume growth right now in my hand. I think the volume growth is a little lesser, but we have been able to clock in at 22% as far as the annual is concerned, and for the quarter, yes, it is a little lower at 19%. You see, we have not reduced our prices. We had a possibility of reducing prices, and our competitors have reduced prices, but we have decided to stick to our pricing so that because the profitability is more important. Could have been easier for us if we had reduced the prices, but that's why we have taken a little hit as far as the top line is concerned from 22 to 19%. But I think it's given us better results as far as the is concerned.
Fair enough. Now, that was the overall company numbers, right? Mr. Agarwal, 19% and 22%, that was for the company as such, full. For specifically the plyboard segment, revenue growth for the segment was about 11 odd percent or so, right?
Whole year. Yes.
Yeah.
We have more growth,
would you
higher growth in our deco division.
Yes.
If you
No, in
really
the
look
plyboard
at
segment,
our
just to stick to that point, would you say it's a sharp slowdown compared to what you've been reporting in the last
really
many quarters now?
Earlier years, you will find. Yes. It's not a sharp slowdown, but yes, you will find a little bit of a slowdown because, but we will recover. Actually, we expected a much lower revenue because our competitors had reduced prices. But then I find to our surprise that no, we have done reasonably well even in this quarter. Otherwise, actually, we are not reducing prices. My competitors are reducing prices. That would have reduced our top line to a bigger extent. So that means that our branding activities, whatever we are doing, and our supply chain is doing a good job.
Okay. No, I mean, the numbers that I have is that the revenue growth is the slowest in the last six quarters. And out of that, 11% revenue growth in plyboards, volume growth is about 5-odd% or so. Can you confirm that?
Yes. Only for the quarter. Only for this quarter, yes.
For the quarter. 11% revenue growth in plyboards, and out of that, volume growth is about 5%. The rest is realization growth.
Yes. For the quarter, yes, the volume growth is only 5%. But that 5% you are, no, but that 5% I think is from Q3 to Q4, not from last year to this year.
Oh, you're saying it's quarter on. Are you sure, sir? You're saying 5% volume growth Q on Q.
Hello. Because I Q on Q, you see, I have this data in front of me that from March 14 to March 15, if you look at quarter 4 to quarter 4 last year, the growth is good. The growth is not bad. 343 to 409. the top line. I don't have only panel, but I don't have only plywood figures. I have a company figures in front of me right now.
Talking about plyboards, and I think the volume growth would be year on year. I think it's unlikely it will be quarter on quarter. But anyway, let's move away from that. But you're saying things will improve. Maintained prices, you did not reduce prices, and you could have had higher growth if you had cut prices. The sense one got was that actually the organized, large organized players like you are in a stronger position during the quarter. You actually had pricing power in the quarter. But what you are saying is kind of opposite to that. You're saying that pricing power was not really there, competitors cut prices, but you managed to hold on prices. Is that what happened?
Yes. You see, we have increased prices in October, November, and we could establish them and retain those price increase as far as we are concerned. But competitors have actually given certain kinds of scheme in the market which have actually effectively reduced their prices. They have not reduced the prices per se, but they have given some schemes in the market which effectively has reduced the prices. Under the present circumstances, the way the market undercurrent is, I don't think that it is really very, very positive. I am happy because even without those positive moves, we are able to maintain and not do a bad job about it.
But why do you say that the market is not very positive? Can you explain that a little bit, sir?
Yeah, certainly I can explain actually. You see, this is a feel when you are dealing with the grassroots level, the kind of contractors, the kind of your dealers, their behavior when you are offering a product or you are talking to them. So this is the feel. If the whole supply chain is moving very smooth and there is a demand at the last mile, then automatically it moves up and we see that kind of a buoyancy in the demand and the way the people talk to us. And if that talking between us and our distributor is the way it is right now, that shows that yes, there is the undercurrents are not good. Otherwise, there is a demand, then you know the way that person talks to you, the way the person demands the material and he adjusts to the kind of demand we make from him. I hope everybody understands that those are the very small fine factors which defines it. There are no data available that within 3 months what has happened in the market. I don't think anybody measures them through the data, but it is done through the kind of behavior you face from your supply chain next to you.
Right. So in a way you are saying that there seems to be a bit of a demand problem right now. Is that correct, sir?
Yes, there is a little bit of a demand problem I can see, yes.
Right. And is this a recent phenomenon over the last couple of months in this quarter, Jan to March? But, or has this been the case earlier as well?
This quarter, yes. This is the quarter we have seen. But recently, again, you see, after the March, usually what happens at the end of the year, there are certain annual schemes which are actually, ending. So at that time, people take a lot of extra material. So that usually subsidizes the demand in the month of April. But in the month of April, what I am seeing that I am able to meet my target. Otherwise, usually the April month usually goes is we are unable to meet our target by any means. Without doing much effort, we have been able to meet our April target already. So that actually tells me that the situation is, I think, improving now. Otherwise, in the month of April is the worst month actually. April and I think the month of October, when the Puja and Diwali are there, they are the two worst months we face in our business.
Okay. That's interesting, sir. Now let's just come to laminates, right? Laminates revenues were up 31%. The utilization is up, capacities are double of last year. Can you just talk us through the picture there? What's the situation?
You see, if you really see our performances in the month, in the years of say 12, 13, 13, 14, we somehow were too much busy in our panel business, and there were certain changes in our organization. Some people moved out and all that happened, and that our focus on to deco division was not so focused. And last year, our chairman's son, Mr. Keshava, has also come into business, and now we have given him charge of this deco division. And we have organized, we have got the right kind of people for that business. So you will find that the last 2 years, we have been constantly improving our deco division. Our deco division performance in terms of percentages, whether it is top line or bottom line, both are improving better than the panel division. And that's because of the focus and the organization structure of this young guy. And there is lot to achieve, because we have been performing badly in last few years, earlier than these 2 years. So, you know, we have lot of scope for improvement right now. So that division will keep on performing better than our panel division.
Right. The rate of growth will be faster. That's what you're saying. But what about margins, sir? Margins are up almost 100 basis points quarter on quarter. I'm talking about operating margins in laminates, but it's still at 8%. Can you tell us what's the plan to increase that?
Yes. You see, you will find that the last year at this time we had a lot of loss because of foreign exchange. I'm talking about the last financial year, 13-14. So this year you will find that instead of that 44 crores, it is only 4 crores. Number two, the euro last year probably was at a high, and our most of imports for the deco division is from euro area, from most of it from Europe, Germany and France and all these areas. This year the euro is at a low, historically low, so that is helping our profit margins. The cost of glue, the phenol, because it's a petro product, has gone down drastically, so that is helping us. And you see, bringing in these new guys and the new blood in the system has actually, every addition on the top line is reducing our total costs of selling, the total cost of manufacturing, because we are utilizing our capacities much higher. As far as laminate is concerned, we are actually on the verge of deciding a capacity expansion from our 4 lakh seat to 6 lakh seats. So maybe that decision will be taken very soon, because we find that within this year probably we will be utilizing the capacities at maybe 100 or maybe 100 plus percentage. We are talking of utilizing our half a day on the closing day also, that on a Sunday we should run our factory for half a day. That is the kind of thinking right now going on.
Thank you very much for your time, sir. Good luck. Appreciate you joining in for that conversation, Mr. Agarwal. Hope to chat with you soon again.
Yeah, Prashant.
Sanjay Agarwal, Managing Director, Century Ply from Kolkata there. Numbers in the fourth quarter a little sluggish, but Mr. Agarwal sounding pretty confident that things will improve and there is a fair bit of scope for improvement in the overall business over the next couple of years. Take a break here. We are back in two with Himendra Hazari.